Cool. We ought to be live, and that ought to have worked out somewhat okay. Welcome everybody to another exciting episode of Conspiracy or Not. Here we come for your listening displeasure. Tonight we have an interesting guest, Chigozie Truth, who is going to be helping us break down and understand numerology and gematria. So, hello everybody, and welcome Chigozie Truth.
Hey,
Break down
everyone.
and
Welcome.
understand
This
numerology
is
and
going to be
gematria.
the first time we've ever talked, so this guy's as new to you guys as he is to me.
Welcome, Chigozie Truth.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for having me on, Rufus. Yeah, I really appreciate it. Really excited to share what we have to see today, and also just learn a lot from you guys as well.
Cool.
Well,
Hi, Amy. How you
welcome,
been?
Chigozie. Oh, I'm hanging in here pretty well. I definitely want to say welcome to Chigozie. I thank him very much for coming on, and I look forward to the show as it progresses.
Yeah, thanks, Amy. Thanks for setting this up. I really appreciate it.
Yeah,
Oh, my pleasure.
so Amy, you've been a supporter, fan, subscriber for some time, yeah?
Oh, yes.
Because him, I had no idea. I didn't even know the guy, didn't know his channel. This is the first time we will have spoken. So, Chigozie, why don't you get us started while I go and correct the title, because I forgot to do that before I started the stream, so I have to go edit the title of the video here. Go ahead and bring us up to speed. Tell us about yourself, who you are, your channel, what your channel's about, how you got started, and just give us all a good warm introduction to who you are.
So I'm Chigozie. My channel is Chigozie Truth, and really what my channel is about is I want to share with the world as simply as possible the fact that the Masonic agenda, these Freemasons, these Jewish Zionists, the Jesuit order, the Masonic order within the Catholic Church, among other secret societies, the Bavarian Illuminati, these people have been conspiring for many, many years, for at least centuries, for as far back as you can even really think. And they've been doing it in a numerical way. And their agenda is about tyranny, about control. It's all about mind control, about leading people down the path of their agenda, pretty much being the ones, the masters of the universe. And their biggest flaw, if you want to look at it like that, is that they use this numerical system of gematria numerology because they practice Kabbalah, a form of Jewish mysticism. And that all goes under the belief that God created the world, combined the letter with the number, with the word. And through that power, if you're able to apply that to scripture, for example, you can see more like God. See what he's thinking and doing and become like him. Likewise, applying that knowledge, you could have become like God. And they're very plainly acting like gods, because if God created the world, combined the letter with the number, then they're simply mocking that by creating everyone's perception of reality that same way. And how do you give people their reality and change the perception? Mainly through the media, through the sports, the news, the politics, the government, the finance, etc., the religion. And you can see how the Bible is encoded and edited and crafted with this numerical language as well. And we'll get into some examples too. And my channel really focuses on keeping it very simple and showing that the news, CNN especially, is employing this knowledge very cleanly. And it's all about pattern recognition. And these numbers, they have a pattern. So certain words will have different, I'll bring up my screen right now. But there's four base ciphers. And in those base ciphers, you can see what these people are coding. And here's gematria, how it really works. Just very simply, Independence Day equals 74 in the full reduction. And to get this value, I is the ninth letter, N is the 14th, D is the 4th. So since N is the 14th, 1 plus 4 is 5. And you see how P is 16, 1 plus 6 is 7. So you just reduce each letter to a single digit and sum everything together, you get 74. So we celebrated on 7/4. And that is the number for Masonic. Masonic 74, Jewish 74, is a holiday, holiday 74. This is all occult 74. This is using the English language, English equals 74. The capital of England is London. London equals 74, 29, like Masonic. Modern Freemasonry, founded in London, England, in 1717, Mason equals 17. So it's really just applying the history that you can, that's well documented. You see how this gematria all works out. And you can just see how statistically, especially, is really impossible for all of this to come together organically. Like, these words didn't just happen to all sum of these things together. They're all coded that way. That's why things like this, Washington, D.C. And the main takeaway is that these are actual names. These aren't like words that you use every single day. These are proper nouns, which means that, that even brings more credence to the fact that they're concocted by this numerical system. Washington, D.C. equals 137. That's the seat of the authority. Authority equals 137 as well. That's the 33rd prime. Masonry equals 33. So a big part component to the study is prime number relationships. Since they can't get just the number 33 by writing out authority, you get the 33rd prime. This is at the White House. White House 137 when you reverse. So I didn't explain these the other base ciphers, but just like how we saw how, you know, W is the 23rd letter, H is the 8th, and so on, you get 133. 2 plus 3 is 5, so you reduce 52. And S, that's a special letter because S is the only letter you can reduce up to two times, because S is 19, 1 plus 9 is 10, 1 plus 0 is 1.
All right, pause right there. just pause. No, you didn't have to stop. I want you to go ahead and leave that up there because I'll ask you about what you're showing.
Okay,
so White House, I'm looking at the full reduction, number 52. So yes. Obviously, there's a lot more letters there, and all those letters, you're going to lay out those letters. So, you know, W is 23, and basically you're going to just add all those together to get the 52, right?
Yes.
So as you lay out all the letters and their number associated, you basically lay them out and add them up, right?
Hang on. Hover over the full reduction there, Chigozie.
Let me highlight him so he stays up. Go ahead.
Okay, you see that with the full reduction, W is not 23. It's 5.
Okay.
Because 2 plus 3.
All right. Fair enough.
Okay.
But nevertheless, so if you were to just write out White House with their associated numbers rather than use the letters, you'd have, I don't know how many letters are there. Going to be 12, right? 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 10 letters. So you'd have 10 numbers, and basically you're going to add all those together, and that's going to give you 52, right?
Correct. Yes.
Okay. My big question I have now right now is, why does it say full reduction? Why are you not adding the 5 and the 2? And I see that there's a 7 below, so it's been done.
Oh, well, yeah, that's the final reduction.
Yes.
Go ahead, Chigozie.
Oh, yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's the final reduction, and it's still significant, like the fact that it sums to 7 and 11, and, you know, 7 times 11 is 77, White House is only 77 meridian, and there's more to it, but for the study that I'm doing and especially for sharing how this is, and the biggest step of this is this intermediary reduction. That's their biggest thing to play with, because, yes, numerology is all about reducing to just a single digit, but these people, they like to use the intermediary reduction mainly, because that's where they code a lot of things. For example, like with life lesson number, like America, United States of America was founded, the Independence Day, July 4th, 1776, a date with 32 life path number. And I call it life lesson number, but really it's a life path number of 5. When you do the life path number calculation, it sums to 5. If you ask any numerologist, they'll tell you it's 5. But the significance is 32 here, and that's what they really want. And also think about the Pentagon. That's five, a pointed thing. Oh, it all goes back to this as well. But there's 32. America equals 32 in that four reduction. And it's founded on a day with a lifeless number of 32. And 104 numerology, Jerusalem equals 32 and 104. Jerusalem, USA, in the middle of that. So it's those types of examples that even show more cleanly how they respect this intermediary reduction. But five is a number in itself, a number for creation, for rebellion. So again, they have their significances, but they love these numbers. For example, when you reverse the alphabetical order, A is 26, Z is 1, and just add them, you get 139, which is the 34th prime number. But 139 is the number for Freemasonry. Freemasonry equals 139. And this brings me to another example. And it's really interesting how this stuff flows together so well, because it's just a good way to bring up examples. We know Tupac Shakur, he died the 13th of September, June 16th through September 13th, 1996. So 13th of September is a lot like 139. In that same cipher, just using the alphabetical order, Tupac Shakur equals 139, dying 13/9. And the more recent example we have is Rick Ocasek, the American singer of the Cars, the lead singer. He had a full birth name that has
Gematria behind it. That's a 323. So that's not actually. Well, it depends. You could look at that, because here in America we go with the month first and then the day. So in other parts of the world, like in Europe, it would be 23, the 23rd of March, which would be 233.
Absolutely, and they code both sides of that. So that's very good observation. They'll pay respect to both of them. They'll, like, for example, on March 23rd, you'll see rituals paying respect to the number 323. For example, Lucifer equals 323 in the Jewish cipher, and then 233, which is the 13th Fibonacci number, and it's the 51st prime number. You'll see rituals for that. So that's really, really good, really good point.
So go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, it's fine. I was just going to say how Rick Ocasek died the 15th of September. He's a good example, too. He's an American singer. In America, they write it 9/15, but they pay respect to the 15/9 when they killed him, because Rick Ocasek equals 159 when you reverse the alphabetical order, just like a Tupac Shakur without reversing was 139, dying 13/9. Another musician now dying 15/9. They're doing it here, and that's the number for the Scottish Rite. Scottish Rite equals 159. So, yeah, that's kind of like how it basically kind of works there. I don't know if you have any other questions on that.
How many ciphers are there?
So there's four main ciphers. Really, there's been things written that show that there can be possible even, like, dozens of ciphers used. And this is just all we've found out. Like, when Zachary K. Hubbard, who started this research back in 2013, he started out with the English ordinal and the four reduction. So the alphabetical order and the rules of numerology. So it's really just this two ciphers starting out with, and you can see how so many things sum to. And it wasn't a year or two later, Derek from Gematrionator, he, with his calculator, he figured out the reverse ordinal, and that kind of put all the pieces together. So really, there's four base ciphers: the English alphabet, the rules of numerology, and reverse rules of numerology. That's all you need to fully see how they're encoding this. But then they have another cipher, the Jewish cipher, and that's always being used very heavily as well. So in total, I mean, if you click on all ciphers in Gematrionator, there's several of them. Although, so a lot of them are, I guess, like, more experimental in a way. And really, just to find out if it's super valid or not, you'd have to apply it to a lot of different things and really see what they're coding and see how it all fits in. But that's why, to keep it simple, especially to show new people, you can literally just take these four ciphers and then maybe add the Jewish into the mix, and you'll see.
Okay, so how old are the four basic ciphers? I mean, where do they all come from originally, each one independently?
They they come from just that time period of around like the 1400s where like modern English was being rolled out and the Gregorian calendar is coming out. That kind of period in time, that's where this whole type of system with the alphabetical order, the rules and numerology and stuff, all was starting to take shape. And that's just, it makes a lot of sense to me that way because it's all around the same time period. And we have the Gregorian calendar, which syncs up perfectly with the Gematria in terms of date numerology. For example, Independence Day equals 74. They're doing on a 7/4. How it all makes sense. How Gregorian equals 58, like calendar, and like Freemasonry as well. But then Gematria in itself is much, much older. You know, millennia older, thousands of years older. So, and Gematria in itself is based on using multiple configurations. It's always been part Kabbalah, and it's always been part of using multiple ciphers configurations to get the whole point across. And original Hebrew Gematria uses way more. I think it's up like 14 ciphers. So like doing Gematria in the raw, like without even the English, you're going to use way more ciphers than even these base ones. So, you know, it's kind of more complex originally, but they've simplified it and made it very applicable because they built the English language and the calendar based in that. That's why it all comes together so well.
Which one's the most important?
The most important is the alphabetical order and the rules of numerology. This is their most pure cipher. And this is something that they have even documented when they're talking about their numerology. And you can even, when you apply it, you see how it's super important. 58, number, the big special number, the Freemasonry. The 74 example with Independence Day. Obama equals, well, now it's 14, but equals 32. Like Barack Obama equals 32. Negro equals 32. They stamp that on black people all the time. That's why Negro equals 59 using the alphabetical order. Black History Month ends on the 59th day of the year, which is February 28th. That's the 59th day of the year. This year was on a date with a life lesson number 42, and they did have plenty of rituals to emphasize that. Because the most hateful word for black people, N-I-G-G-E-R, that equals 42. Jackie Robinson wearing number 42. February in this full reduction, most pure cipher equals 42. And that's why Black History Month is in that month as well. If you look at the other months, January through December, you won't get 42, only that in this full reduction.
I have a question regarding one of the words you had up, like when you first, like early on, like 10 minutes ago, when I was asking why didn't they reduce all the way down? It was a large number that at the bottom, rather than a single digit, there were two 11s, and I forget what word you had on the screen.
Oh, okay. It was a White House.
Okay, so how come we're not adding the one and the one? Why do we have 11? Because the other two numbers reduced down to 7. The double digit numbers are, I understand, master numbers.
Oh, exactly. So because of that, in numerology, they don't need to be reduced. So that kind of pays respect to them, as in. And the full numerology, like if you're doing your life path number for your birthday, if it ends up being 11, it's going to be 11, like it wouldn't be 2. So it's just following that rule of it being a master number. And a good example of that is the word banker equals 33 with that, because K being the 11th letter, so you reduce everything else but K, that stays as 33.
Okay, so then, all right, so when it reduces down to one of the master numbers, it just stops there.
Yes.
Got it.
But again, they also, like, them calling their Gematria, they will also not do that. So, for example, they'll put out a ritual. There'll be a K in it, like someone's name, but it'll all sync up perfectly. Because what I'm trying to say is, although that's a rule of numerology, it's not, like, concrete. It's not like you have to do it. And that doesn't mean that this 24 is irrelevant then. You know what I mean? Like, it's still, they can still easily use this number in some ritual. Or for whatever purpose. But for bank, I just use Bank of America as an example because of their logo. Their logo is 3 11s. 11 is a master number. These are the master masons. We have the 3 11s as their logo. These are the bankers. And then banker equals 33. So it's, you know, very interesting stuff like that as well.
I just want to input here. We had a question from Ghost in the prison, and he asked, what is the purpose of Gematria anyway?
So the purpose of Gematria to these people in power is they use it as a way to carry out rituals, to act like God, to communicate. And it's more so going back to the belief that they're Kabbalists. So Kabbalah, they believe that God created the world, combined the letter of the number. Since these people are playing God, they're using God's powers, essentially, to do that as well. So that's kind of its purpose. And then each number, like that's what they call it, spelling, mm-hmm. because each word is comprised of these numbers, which are all different frequencies. So it's like having these different frequencies and different words and casting spells. So that type of route of thinking as well is also why this gematria is important. So just looking at it from that type of standpoint kind of shows how they're using it. And again, words like spelling help to clue us in as to what they really think about this language.
So what is throw spelling into your search box here.
Spelling equals 41, that's the 13th prime. One Freemason equals 122, and the Francis Bacon cipher. And that cipher takes into account the capital letters. So A is 1, Z is 26. Then for each capital letter, you add 26. So A will be 27, B 28, etc. And spelling equals 122. Zionist 40 and 94. And even then, like, it's hard to make too much of an association with like exactly why these numbers are here. Like I don't fully exactly know.
So the Francis Bacon cipher, because I don't know. I mean, I don't know how much you and Amy have communicated, but we have had not only we've had Zach on here, but we've also had Derek, and this is his website, right? Derek created the Gematronator website.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so we've had Derek on here, and and I've asked him many of the same questions that I'll be asking you.
Okay.
And if I'm not mistaken, Francis Bacon is a relatively new cipher, right? Is that a new cipher?
By new as in like from just like them using it like in...
How long has that cipher been around?
Since Francis Bacon.
Yeah, like, I mean...
He used that.
Yeah. So it could be since... It's definitely credited to him. But it's one of those things, at least in my perspective, it's kind of like looking at Thelema and how they said it's from Aleister Crowley in 1904. But based on how they code Thelema everywhere, they've paid tribute to it. I personally think Thelema is much, much older, but you know, Aleister Crowley just kind of gets the credit. So it's one of those things with Francis Bacon, like the way I kind of process it, like I think that cipher's been around maybe since the beginning of the alphabetical of the modern English alphabet, maybe a little later, but maybe he just got it attributed to him. So that's why it's hard for me to say exactly how old it is.
Well, Amy, you said he used it. How do we know that?
That was my understanding. Now, I could be entirely incorrect on that. I would not say that's an impossibility. But I had read somewhere, and I cannot recall precisely where, but that he would put certain things into that kind of a cipher.
Well, I do know that coding language, coding writing is a real thing. That is an undisputable fact. Back in the old days when you had to hand write a letter and give it to a courier or a messenger and he would get on a horse and travel sometimes for days, weeks, even months before delivering that letter, you know, not counting, for people who didn't have like carrier pigeons and crows and you know, think birds that would get a message, you know, real fast. Messages were often intercepted. Even if it was a pigeon or a crow that were often used, sometimes they would actually be shot down and messages would be intercepted. So I know that coding messages, languages, and writing is a real thing. What I'm wondering is, how do we know... let me try to formulate this question. How do we know which ciphers are like original to, I don't know, something like very old, like, and how, which one's the oldest, by the way? Which is the first cipher that we know for sure existed?
Although I would say the full reduction, because that's just taking alphabetical order, and you're simply applying the numerology to each digit and nothing else. And it's the full reduction, as in you're just applying full numerology to everything, no sort of exceptions, no nothing. And it's also the cipher that when you take it and go as far back as to the Bible, you'll notice how sacrifice equals 46. Genesis 46, the first part of that begins with a sacrifice. So Genesis 46 begins with a sacrifice. Sacrifice equals 46. And then going back in history, a lot of sacrifices happening in days with 46 numerology. It's applying this through history, going as far back as possible, seeing the patterns, and then seeing just the logic behind the cipher. It's how you can see how it's very original, and it's the very basic. And likewise, reversing the alphabetical order and doing the same. Everything else seems to be like an extension of something, like the Jewish cipher that's based on more so like the Latin alphabet, but it's still very relevant, and they've utilized it. But I definitely see what you're saying. I mean, it also definitely makes sense that they could have just started off with these ciphers and then expanded maybe with the Jewish, maybe a couple hundred years from there, but still like so long ago because they've been using it for so long.
Well, I do know that the full reduction is also called Pythagorean.
Yes.
And if Pythagoras was using it, obviously he was doing something Greeky. not English, but the same principles that he used, I believe, are what are applied in the full reduction method.
See, man, a lot of this stuff goes really over my head, you know. Like, I do think that they use numbers like 33, for an example. Like, you see that as a repeating number almost everywhere. But a lot of this stuff just, I don't know, like, you're making a pretty compelling case. Like, I gotta say that, man. I had one question. Like, I used to talk to one guy years ago who used to be convinced that there was this 777 code everywhere. Have you ever heard of something similar to that?
I haven't really. I'm familiar with like 777 in general, but not like a 777 code being used everywhere. I've never really heard something much like that, but it's interesting.
Okay, well, yeah, I just wanted to put that out there. But yeah, you're making a pretty decent case, better than I've seen anyone try and explain this entire gematria thing.
Oh, thanks. I'm really glad I'm getting this across, because that's definitely like my goal. Because I know that it's definitely like, it's a different way of thinking. It's newer to a lot of people, and if I can convey this information in just a clear enough way, they'll be great. And the beauty of it, that's why I'm excited to go to CNN, because that's like where I focus on my channel, is taking people through the rituals and coding step by step by just opening up the news propaganda and seeing how it's all coded by the numbers. Like how stuff with Giuliani and Trump, it's always by the number 39. Donald Trump appointed Giuliani president. I think it was 39, or not president, excuse me, his like lawyer. 39 days before Giuliani's birthday, New York 39. Israel's all but the number 39, 93, like Knesset and stuff like that. It's a number used in Israel because Saturn 93. So these things have a lot of these occult things based behind them, like based in Thelema, Saturn, the Keeper of Time. You can keep it really, really simple. These two men from, well, first off, these are two men from New York, the 11th state. Today's the 11th. That's also why they're here. But with Donald Trump propaganda, you can expect numbers 29, 25, 47. It's always these base ciphers. And looking at CNN all the time, or all the news outlets that use these numbers, like Breitbart and stuff, you can see.
Let me ask you this question so I can let the chat roll on. There was a question that I overlooked from Sandra. She said... ask him what is your take on inverted numbers? For example, many times we don't find the exact number, but they're inverted.
As in like a 9 versus a 6, or inverted as in reflection 4774?
Just answer both, because she's not here. Okay. to clarify. So just go ahead and consider it both ways. What do you, and I'm not a hundred, maybe Sandra can clear that up for me.
Sure, because I mean, because they also could be she could be talking about an entire a concept that's I'm not even familiar with, because it kind of sounds familiar in that sense. But if I inverted, she means 4774. They treat them just as the same number. So like a lot of times, and that's why the dates. That's why like in England they'll call it 4th of July.
Yeah. Okay. But, she cleared it up and she said no. Gave examples. So 23 or 32, 41 okay, or 14. Perfect. So yeah, a reversed, a reflection. Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, and the inverted. I mean, that's a good way to put them as well. So yeah, they treat them like in numerology. It's also kind of that rule of they're treated as the same, and they do pay attention to that as well. Like another good example, 25th Amendment. Remember Donald Trump and the whole 25th Amendment thing? 25th Amendment equals 97, the 25th prime number. So using a prime number relationship to represent 25. And here it equals 92. That's a reflection or the inversion of 29. Trump equals 25 and 29. And you see how they're playing this game with the four reductions. Trump, just using the alphabetical order, rules of numerology, that most important cipher, that equals 25. And when you reverse the alphabetical order and do those rules of numerology in each digit, you get 29. So they're keeping these ciphers. And when you write 25th Amendment, you get reflection of 29 now. And so you can kind of even visually see. That's why I really like how Derek built this calculator. It's very visual to see the riddles. So unfortunately, this is a piece that doesn't have like an update time on it. They usually do. They're just giving us a timeline, though. But it's all, you know, dates by the numbers. So I think anyone doing this research, a good way to start is doing the date numerology first. Today's a date with 33, life lesson number. And today was a very big day for Brexit in England, causing a lot of different movements in the financial markets. And Donald Trump equals 60. There's plenty more today that they did. But it's really about looking at this news, seeing all the different rituals that they put out.
I have a question.
Yes?
I don't know if you've noticed recently that we've seen a lot fewer headlines with quotes. Have you noticed that?
I've noticed that. Now that you're mentioning that, I definitely have noticed that.
The thing is, there was one point where I went in and pretty much ran the numbers on everything that was in quotes, and I put a comment on your channel. And it was like the very next day when I watched the stuff you were presenting, I'm going, where are all the quotes? And I keep watching, and every so often there'll be one. But it was like almost immediately after. I mean, it was like I said, the next day they stopped using quotes. And I wonder if there's a connection. But it was just really kind of freaky.
I see what you're saying, because I'm even noticing it now. There's just like a lot less quotes on this front page than you kind of normally would see. Like all of this, I just see, unless I'm skipping one, the Jewish lobby, and there was the king down here. There's like a couple of them.
Yeah, really, I mean, in the headlines, especially.
Mm-hmm.
The headlines, they were using quotes on things that really made no sense to be using quotes. You didn't need quotes. And so I could tell that since it made no sense to put the quotes in there, that it must be pointing to that particular word or phrase. So I almost always found something significant when I'd run the numbers. And now it's like I'm not really sure where I should. Now there, I think, go back down just a wee bit. Maybe it's something on my masters of the air. Okay, mm-hmm. That is in quotes. Yeah, okay, and I'm betting that would come up with something.
Yeah, it definitely would. We can do that and then refreeze. But I'm glad you brought the quotes. They love to do that. Put gematria, and by default, it's always the numbers for, you know, Freemasonry, just this agenda. New World Order 177.
Saturn
93. Saturn 93 there too.
Then you got your 69. Oh my god! So yeah, I like I said, I kept finding that kind of stuff in them quotes.
Well, the 69, by the way, is the alchemical sign for Gemini.
Yes.
Those are the twins.
Absolutely.
And that's what's on the top of the Masonic arch or whatever they call it.
That's right.
Yep.
Absolutely.
And by the way, speaking of Gemini and the twins, there's a brand spanking new Will Smith movie coming out called Gemini Man, where he plays himself. And so Will Smith is in the movie twice as twins, not twins, but it represents the twins because he's playing himself and he interacts with himself in the movie, and it's called Gemini Man. But before we get too far off, I do have another question, from, Iman Pudama. Has Chigozie Truth heard of the quote, 10 and not 9, 10 and not 11 passage in the Kabbalist texts, the cipher Yetzira? Could that date 9/11 have been a reference to it?
I very well think it absolutely could have been. I mean, that's something that I haven't fully, researched or looked too much into. I haven't read all of the texts, but if you look at a lot of things in the Talmud, for example, Baba Kamal 113a says it's okay for a Jew to circumvent a Gentile through deception in a legal setting. And you see how they're putting A113 and all sorts of Pixar things. They put 113 everywhere, dishonest 113, mainstream, green screen, Scottish, they all send the 113. So seeing that as well, and like how Tisha B'Av equals 9/11 in the Jewish cipher, for me to say that there's not a riddle with those numbers and 9/11, I'm sure there very well could be some connection, and I would like to look more into that.
There's another question, but I think we've already answered it. Who's the ones in control? Is it a religious cult? I would, before Chigozie answers, I would already say that if it's religious, then yes, it's a cult.
I agree.
I'd like to answer to that. Irrespective of lineage, religion, or affiliation, by their behavior, they are psychopaths.
There they are.
So whether it's religious or some bloodline or some secret society or societies, it doesn't matter. What matters is their behavior is psychopathic, ergo they are psychopaths.
Do all the ciphers work essentially the same? In by that I mean, do they always, like, I know that you use different ways of counting, but do you always add them and then reduce?
Always do that, because, for example, the English, the alphabetical order without the rules of numerology, that's without any sort of reduction, and that's a very valid cipher as well. So this is what they pretty much take these four base ciphers and tell a story with the numbers. That's kind of the best way to explain it in terms of how you see them. Like, government equals 133. So let's just assume that 133 was irrelevant. Let's just say that we don't know if they use that cipher yet. Well, then when you read out White House, you get 133 as well. So why does the White House, the head of the seat of the government, both equal 133? And then again, White House is not like a synonym to the government. It's an actual house, an actual place, really what the main government is. It's where the president lives. So it's just left like that. And then, 137, 100, you can do the same with 137 and like authority. This is all without reduction, but they're both 137. Jesus equals 74, Muhammad. I can't spell it Muhammad, but if you spell Muhammad correctly, like Muhammad Ali's first name.
Yes. I'll get it right.
Muhammad, that equals 74. It equals 74 using alphabetical order. The other, Jesus, 74. Look what Muhammad Ali died at 74 years old. And it's this type of pattern. That's why So the unfortunate thing is Zach Hubbard, who started this research, he had a lot. He's on his 19th YouTube channel now because they keep taking him down because he keeps exposing them. And his first channel, he had all these predictions on, and he was predicted that Muhammad Ali would die at 74 simply because of that pattern. I mean, there's more to the riddle as well, but Muhammad equals 74. And they like to kill black men and sync it up with Jesus Christ and stuff like that. Jesus 74, Jesus Christ 74. And here's another example. We know how old the Bible is in terms of not, we don't all know exactly how old the Bible is. We know it's older than all of us, at least. Jesus Christ equals 74, but Jesus equals 74. Messiah, he's the Messiah, 74. He died on the cross. Cross equals 74. He spoke in parables. Parables equals 74. Gospels, the book of Jesus. Gospel equals 74. So and when you see how Jesus, cross, Messiah, gospel, parables, and more all equals 74, you then just wonder. And again, these are numbers for the Masonic, for Jewish, English, holiday, gematria. And you see how they put 74 all throughout their propaganda. The answer is always just very, it just points exactly to this gang every single time. And it's stuff like that that makes me question, like, it already shows Jesus is not his, was not his name or any of that. I don't know how this all syncs up. It just shows that they very well have their hand in these religions and these stories that we've been told. So there's some other very simple patterns. And sometimes you'll say, think there's a pattern here. You might not get it right away, but it's a lot of very clear things. Even as simple as this, like I know some people might not really understand without seeing a lot of it, but if you notice in a lot of their pictures, it's always the red and blue pillars of Freemasonry and then the black and red Jesuit watercolors. That is in at least 80%, 70-80% of the photos on CNN. You see it here with this. They like to pair red and blue very cleanly inside their photographs. It's a very, very common thing.
Red and blue, if I'm not mistaken, represents the two hemispheres of the brain, which is the masculine, the feminine, the logical, the emotional. Red and blue has just a ridiculous amount of significance. One of the things I have noticed is that a disgusting number of logos and business name signs and stuff like that. I mean, just look at the NBA, red, white, and blue, but it's mostly red and blue. You showed Bank of America a minute ago. That's red and blue. Look at Coke and Pepsi, red and blue. You've probably already been to, you know, just checked out tons and tons of logos. Oh, you're on sports logos. But yeah, look at how much red and blue there is going on in each logo. Business logos use it.
Like 5% of newsrooms are blue as well, right?
Yeah.
Well, blue is supposed to be the color that imparts a feeling of truth and trust.
Blue,
and that is why they use the blue.
If I'm not mistaken, blue is feminine and red is masculine, and it's also a reference to Venus and Mars.
That is true. And that's, I really appreciate that the breakdown you just gave me, because that's the symbolism behind these colors is very significant. And that's like why, like those reasons among their other Masonic reasons is why they'd like to empower these things all the time. And it's just, that's why it's sad when people say, well, it's America, red, white, and blue. They literally think that's the extent of why everything's red, white, and blue. It's like, well, then why is England's flag? Why is France? Why are most flags red, white, and blue? And obviously, it's just the colors of this agenda.
Go ahead. I was just going to say, all you got to do is turn on the news or like Good Morning America, which is, our breakfast show. I have to say that because we have a lot of overseas viewers. And just pay attention to how many times you'll see, like, especially when there's two women who are anchors or talking heads or presenters. Watch how often one is in wearing a red dress and the other isn't wearing a blue dress. Watch commercials. Pay attention to how often you see one person in red, one person in blue. It's overwhelming. It's overwhelming.
Yes.
It really is. I'm. Yeah. It's. That's really, like, it's really good that we're talking about this, because I think that's one for anyone who's like new to try to pick this stuff up. I think that's just the easiest thing is just look for the red and blue. It's just all over the place. I mean, we go to Fox News here and it's everywhere. They do it all over the place. And it's just the red and blue pillars of Freemasonry. I mean, they even have it here. This guy with the red jersey here, the blue. It never failed.
Hey, and don't you remember growing up, you know, everyone had to pick who was your favorite, the Red Ranger or the Blue Ranger?
Yeah.
Look at Republican versus Democrat, red and blue. I mean, yeah. We could do red and blue for hours and just showing just examples nonstop for hours.
Oh, seriously. And that's just the thing. Like, it's so prolific. I mean, you can really sit it for all day and just show all different times of them doing it. I mean, through this presentation, we're just going to see more as it comes. There's a few things on this page, like Kurt Cobain, he was murdered by the numbers. And by that, you know, I always entertain the fact that these people could be faking their deaths. I mean, I can't prove that they're really dead or what happens to them. But whenever they're reported dead or suicide or anything, this gang is behind it in some way or fashion. They report it, they're behind it. And you can see all the time by researching their deaths. And through this research, along with the sports, the murder by numbers, the murder of celebrities is the most popular thing. And I mean, other researchers have said it. If I go on my channel and look at my view count, all my most viewed videos are all murdered by numbers. That's just how it works. People are interested in seeing how the celebrities are dying, which is, you know, it's a good way to see through this. And I try to want to see, like, say I clicked on this as well. I mean, they've been doing a lot of this style stuff.
Isn't Kurt Cobain also part of the 27 Club?
I believe so. Let's look him up. Kurt Cobain.
The Jimi Hendrix, what's her name? Damn it, right on tip of my tongue. What's her name? Who was that singer, female?
Oh, Janis, I know who you, Janis Joplin.
Janis Joplin, yeah, thank you.
Ooh, I love her.
And who else? There was somebody else that's, do a quick search for the 27 Club, see who's on that list, because there's several.
Sure, and we can talk about this real quick, too, 27 Club.
Amy Winehouse, I think Karen McCardle said Amy Winehouse might be on that list.
I think.
Jim Morrison, Jimi Hendrix. Yep. Right.
Yeah, we'll go back to the list.
Fellow man said Jim Morrison, yep.
It's a pretty big list. And the thing is, these are just musicians mainly. And they're saying identify, but there's plenty more. Like recently, this BBC reporter, Hannah Yusuf, she was murdered at 27 by this gang. Of course, you know, she's not going to be on this list. Fredo Santana. Oh, I forgot that he even died. Yeah, he's part of the 27 Club. So that all goes back to, I know, it's always, you know, deeper than even what I'm seeing. I always entertain that as well. But the word ritual equals 27. And that very important four reduction cipher. Ritual 27.
See, this is where it starts to get a little interesting for me. I mean, I was watching your videos earlier today, and like I was telling you privately before we went live, to, you know, just slow down your presentation, because there's a lot of people out here like me who really don't spend much time at all. In fact, I spend almost no time at all. I only watch some of my friends who do it. But your presentations move really, really fast. So either you expect your entire audience to be completely up to speed, or you're just going over the heads of a lot of people. So just like I asked you privately, and I'll ask again, as you're giving your presentation, just try to slow it down a little bit, and maybe take that into consideration on your future video production, because you always have new people coming along, and when you move that fast, you're just flying right over people's heads, man. And by the way, how long you been doing this? Because I mean, you're like Zach Hubbard and Derek combined with the speed at which you move.
I've been doing this since I got into the research in 2016. That's when I found Zach's channel and found the work. But then I started putting out videos a year later in 2017. So I've been doing this for about like 2 years, maybe coming on three now, maybe I guess two and a half years. So not terribly long, but I guess long enough to just snap everything together. But yeah, I definitely try to be more mindful to be slow. I'll definitely like showing these examples now. We're talking about writing my numbers. This is super repetitive, so it'll be easy to keep on showing these. So Ritual, since that's 27, they have another cipher. They're called Dian. And this is another cipher. A lot of, you know, biblical things are based on this as well. But sacrifice equals 27 in that one. But just using the base ciphers, you don't even need this 27. You can just go Ritual 27, and it's always Ritual Murder. And I know it kind of, just the skeptic, it's like, oh, it's conjecture. You're trying to plug a word with this and that. But it just goes to the fact that you see how they're applying it all the time. Ritual 27, 81. I want to show you another example real quick before we look at more people.
I was reading the chat. Did you already do suicide?
So suicide equals 47, 34. I didn't do the gematria of that yet, but this is the gematria of it. And they report a lot of suicides and stuff on dates with 119, 47 connections, 34, and 70. But the connections here is murder equals 34, like suicide. So they're all related. 34 is a murderous...
A mirror. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Then they pay attention to this all the time. They pay homage to this all the time. They code 7447 in killings. One of the most popular killings of all time is a killing of Jesus Christ, which equals 74. And Masonic is a killing cult. Masonic, Lucifer. Yeah, Lucifer also equals 74. Like, and this is the thing. Lucifer is 74, like Jesus. I'm just like, okay, you know, what are these people really trying to code?
And how old was Jesus when he died?
33.
Yeah, oh my God.
And then
just like Superman.
And also,
who also
we
wears
might
red
want
and blue.
To point out that the 47 is the number of degrees on the compass in the compass and
yep.
square.
I was gonna mention that one too.
Yep.
The compass is usually almost always, but most of the time, yes. But they do have their compass set on, depending on which image that you're looking at, where that image, who's using it. But yes. almost always it's 47. And I don't know the other set angle that they use. It's a little more steep. It's more like the, what is that pyramid?
Maybe it's 33 degrees.
It could be. It's a real steep pyramid that's a tomb. Was that Aleister Crowley's tomb or something like that? It's like a really, really steep pyramid. Maybe that's the other angle, and that could be 33. Could be.
Yeah, because if it's steep, 33 sounds about right.
That definitely makes sense to me. I've seen how they have other measurements because I looked it up as well. Yeah, that 47 is their most common, and when you add that to the square, which is 90 degrees, that's 137 degrees. Going back to the 33rd prime.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Gandalf, you were going to say something a second ago.
Oh,
I thought Gandalf was Amy and Gandalf were starting speaking over each other a moment ago.
We were arguing with each other. Well, one thing I wanted to point out about the compass and square is that in every four-sided figure, the angles equal 360 degrees. So if you take the 90 degrees and the 47 for your 137, subtract that from 360, the remaining angles total 223 degrees, which is probably another reason amongst many that we see a lot of 223s.
Mm-hmm.
And if you see any 1115, there we go. That's your 111.5 degrees for each of the remaining angles.
That's really interesting. That explains that 115 too.
Yeah, there you go. You're missing a one, but yeah. Should be 1115, and who knows, maybe in another cipher that's got bigger numbers.
Yeah, I do wonder that too. I think about going back to the 33. Another example is the 33rd state of the United States of America, which is Oregon. That equals 74. So 33 being paired with 74, just like how Jesus Christ dying at 33, his name equals 74. That's a very special pairing that they use all the time. And just Oregon equals 74, the 33rd state. And that's the only state that sums to 74 using the alphabetical order.
And it's got the 88 like Trump.
Mm-hmm. Trump 88, 47 reflection, 25. These are numbers connecting to time. Time equals 47, 25.
Are you familiar with the analemmas?
Yes, I am. And that's why they code 88 for time as well. With
right,
the
right. Because the sun and the moon are used as timekeepers, their cycles, and the sun and the moon both make an analemma in the sky over their respective cycles. So yeah, 88 is absolutely a reference to time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's the beauty of this is like those type of examples are so prolific in this research, and we see how they use it all the time. Like Trump equals 88. He's playing the role of Saturn, the keeper of time. That's why he's super coded with the numbers for Saturn. And he had the 88 generals, you know, endorsing him and stuff like that. So it's these types of examples that really hit home and that really would help anyone to see. Real quick, I just got an idea. I don't know how well, I mean, this could work well. I see this July 4th. That's a date of birth. So in these murder rituals, very special numbers to see are numbers for the death, killing, murder, and sacrifice. And here's the main one to look for, 38. Using the alphabetical order, death equals 38. B4, E5, etc. Using the full reduction, killing equals 38. Murder equals 38 in the full reduction. When you reverse the alphabetical order, RIP, that equals 38 when you reverse the alphabetical order without reducing each letter. So with these four base ciphers, you get 38 with death, killing, murder, and RIP. Even destroy equals 38. Cancel equals 38. So it becomes just type of destructive number is how they love to use it. So this is something that maybe is like, it wouldn't be hard to do, to throw this into a computer program, just a column. Plug a date numerology in and see how many give you 38 date numerology. That's something I might do in my own free time. But just looking at some of these, you'll get a lot of, I mean, look, March 8th, 1973, Ron Pigpen McKernan dying at 27 years old, 3/8 in 73. The numbers for death, killing, murder, and the thing that doesn't follow that pattern of 38, but very prevalent, sacrifice. Sacrifice using the alphabetical order equals 73. So they use this number all the time. Ritual sacrifice also equals 73 in the full reduction. So ritual sacrifice and sacrifice both have gematria 73. And we have someone dying 3/8 in 73. Death, killing, murder, 38. Sacrifice, 73. That is exactly how they do this. And, you know, I'm not surprised that there's another 73 also here.
I wonder if his name doesn't have some gematria going on.
I got two questions from the chat I'd like to get at you before the chat rolls by too far.
Sure.
Regarding Oregon, the question, I think it was Ghost that asked a moment ago. Yeah. Wait a minute. No, somebody else. You didn't tag me, so it's hard for me to find it. I need my damn reading glasses.
Well, while you're looking there, I'm just going to mention that in Jewish reduction, Pigpen equals 30. Well, no, that's 37. I'm sorry. Okay. I've got 37 on my mind.
it does
equal 93 in Francis Bacon and 133 in Frank Baconis.
I think it was Ghost, and I'm just having a hard time finding it because it's the print is here. Here it is. It was Ghost. So are you saying, regarding Oregon, are you saying that they knew, the powers that be, that they know to name Oregon the name that they gave it in 1859 with numerology in mind?
Yes, they knew that for sure. In fact, I mean, in 1776, they probably had it all. No, way before 1776, they probably had it all mapped out. And in 1859, not only did they have the name, I mean, they even knew why they wanted that particular piece of land in 1859, on which day. Like, they had the entire thing scripted. So, yes, they definitely knew, you know, beforehand.
See, a lot of this is pretty believable. Like, the entire United States itself is a corporation that was basically a giant Freemasonic experiment. So,
yeah,
I'm not surprised that the entire thing from top to bottom is encoded with all types of numerology, codes, weird ciphers like you're describing. Like, look at Washington, D.C. Like, that was a giant, like, physical representation of Freemasonry that you can see in space. Just look on Google Earth. It's crazy.
All right, here's the other question from Sampa Views. And forgive me, I don't mean to insult, but I'm only going to assume that English is not your first language based on the sentence construction. So I do apologize for that. I'm not trying to insult you, but this is really hard for me to read. I'll just reverse that. Can you question about time in clock? How see the number like 88 minutes of day, 137 minutes to midnight, things like that? So I don't know if that made enough sense for you to answer in the question form.
Oh, I think I'm gonna understand, like, how can you maybe, like, if you see this on the clock, how would you kind of interpret it and stuff like that? I think by that, it depends on, so there is an organic side to this, first off. Like, for me, for example, I see 223 on the clock, on all sorts of things almost every single day. Like, it's kind of crazy how I just see it. So there's, like, some organic side to, like, how numbers are appearing in your life. And they can have some meaning that you might not even know the meaning yet. You have to kind of just figure it out. Unlike decoding the Masonic information, for example, the 38, we see all the meaning for that is death, killing, murder, and sacrifice. They let us know the meaning of this through repetitive application. So, but that being said, they would use that as well. Like, for example, 88 miles per hour in Back to the Future, that's them putting, like, 88 on the screen to represent one thing. And if you see 808 on a clock, though, and you wake up, you see 808, you know, again, that's, it's more of an organic layer, if that kind of makes sense.
Well, I don't even know if this question is even really that accurate. There's 88 minutes of day. I don't even know, like, 88 minutes of day.
So I think he might also mean, like, the 88th, like, how the 88th minute of the day be represented on the clock.
The 88th. The minute of the 88th minute of day. Maybe. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the 88th minute of day would be what, like, one?
Which leaves 137 minutes to midnight. That makes more sense.
Okay. They do that type of stuff in their rituals. They'll have riddles about that as well. Like, they'll sync things up. So if he's wondering if they apply that type of thing, they do. They definitely do that. Like, Trump will do something at the whatever minute of the day. So that's something that they do. It's not, like, as prolific, and it's something you kind of have to put more thought behind to really see how they're syncing it up. Like, for example, they give us his time of death. It could be part of that as well, but if they don't give it to us, you know, it's probably not that relevant in this particular situation.
I do want to mention that I ran Ron Pigpen McKernan.
Mm-hmm.
And there is an interesting, at least I think it is, connection. In English ordinal, we have 193. And wow. 193 is the 44th prime number. And what does kill equal?
44.
Yes, sir.
That's excellent. Thanks so much, Amy. That's wonderful. And I really appreciate you doing that, because it just shows how in your face this is, how
anyone
can just put the numbers in the calculator, or you can do it with pen and paper, or do it in your head, but you put in a calculator, Ron Pigpen McKernan, as they have it stylized on here as well, equals 193, the 44th prime, kill equals 44. Execution equals 44 as well. And it also equals 86, reversing and reducing, blood sacrifice equals 86. The numbers for blood sacrifice, ritual sacrifice, used all the time. Blood sacrifice 86, like his name, Ron Pigpen McKernan. And he's just, I mean, he's one dying at Well, 27. Pigpen, 67. Blood sacrifice, 67. And that full reduction importance.
Okay. I saw that 67 and it didn't really click in my brain because I, you know, I can't remember what a lot of the words come up to. But I'm glad you got that because when I saw the 67, I didn't think it was significant, but then you pointed to the fact that it probably is significant.
Well, that's one of their main numbers. They use 67 in so many of these murder rituals. Like, if anyone wants any sort of homework, I love how they CNN, Wikipedia, they compile these things. They make this stuff so much more accessible. You can just take an afternoon, do the date numerology behind all these, do their name gematria, see how many days from their birthday they died, and you're going to get blood sacrifice, death, killing, murder, sacrifice, ritual sacrifice numbers the entire way. And we'll see another more examples of that. I already see Slada Gutaras dying December 10th, 2014. 12/10 in numerology, you drop the zero, so that's 121, blood sacrifice, 121. So we see that someone dying December 10th. We see how Pigpen equals 67, like blood sacrifice. And then Ron Pigpen McKernan equals 86, the blood sacrifice. And this is the first person we're looking at. I randomly kind of picked someone that had a clickable name, and you see how it comes up. And it's excuse me?
No, go ahead. Just finish. I got a question.
Oh, sure. I could just quickly see how many days from his birthday he died. Because to me, that's my favorite thing to do, because it just really seals the deal, as in, like, when, like, if they're dying a specific day from their birthday, then it's more, and then it becomes more than just putting things in a calculator and seeing what comes up. When you see they're dying number of days from their birthday by those same numbers on date numerology that matches as well, like you can see March 8th, 73, dies in a date with, that's his 67th day of the year. It's these types of things that become so mind-blowing. So we were just talking about 67, blood sacrifice equals 67, and this full reduction, very important cipher. Pigpen, just using the alphabetical order, 67. And of all the days in the year, he dies March 8th, the 67th day of the year. This is why Murder by Numbers is such a good way to see how they're doing this.
All right, I got three questions for you.
Sure.
First, I want to get to Sandra's question before the chat rolls by. What would be your take on 64, since Israel equals 64 and it has no other name all over the world?
So that's a really good question, and I have a really good answer for that. That goes back to Revelation 3:9. I'll bring that up. Revelation 3:9 that talks about the synagogue of Satan. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee. And that's Revelation 3:9, a lot like 39 books of the Old Testament that they're into. Synagogue of Satan equals 64, like Israel. And think about the 64 squares on the chessboard about, you know, control, manipulation. That is why. And it all goes back to the Lima. And so I'm so glad they're asking this question. Israel, the Lima, Zion, that's all one pattern. They all equal 64. So, and it's why I explained. The Lima is a cult religion. They honor the number 93.
And that 44.
Oh, exactly. Zion 44, like the Lima as well. And Israel. Zion, Israel, and Thelema all equal 44 as well. Thelema.
And by the way, I would recommend, if you're going to go looking up Bible passages, I would recommend, do you ever use Bible Hub?
I've heard of it, but I haven't really used it like that. But
Bible Hub, I'm telling you right now, I got Bible Hub on speed dial. They are absolutely the shit.
Oh, nice.
And the reason why is because it automatically gives you all of the translations. So all the different versions, like over on the left, like if you look up, go look up the Revelation 9 again real quick.
Okay. Ooh, okay. Yeah.
So if you look on the left-hand side, it gives you all the versions. Now, hang on, slow down. take your mouse and just hover over any single word. Go over to the right side where it says Study Bible. It says the Church of Philadelphia there.
Yeah.
Just hover your mouse over any single word or phrase in that paragraph.
Yeah.
Just move it around until, because most words and or phrases are hyperlinks that will take you to the etymology of the word.
Oh, like these blue links?
Uh-huh. And you can go, yeah, not just in the highlighted blue, but also in other areas of the paragraph. If there are tons and tons of hyperlinks, so if you're interested in the etymology of a particular word or phrase, plus it has literally every version translation on the left-hand side, so you can compare translations right there, bang, bada boom, bada bing. So Bible Hub is the shit. I do a lot of research on Bible Hub.
This really is the shit. I'm going to start using this more often. Thanks a whole lot. Appreciate that recommendation.
Awesome.
I do have another question, or an observation, and I guess I'll get your feedback. A minute ago, when you looked up a date somewhere in December, and you said, and you added up the date, it was, okay, December 12th, and then you added up the days and whatever. Are you aware that September, October, November, and December are not the 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th month, but they are the 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th month?
Yes, and that's another really good observation.
How does that affect, you know, if you're, okay, so you're aware. So how does that affect, you know, if you're going to use gematria and you're going to say, okay, this date is in December, and you throw in 12 plus the days, and then you get your number. I mean, how does that affect your gematria? Are you using the correct version or the correct date? Because if December is not the 12th month, because DEC in Latin is dec for deca, which is 10, September is Latin again for 7, October is 8, November, novus is 9. So, you know, somehow our calendar is cattywampus. And so if you're going to use dates in that way, how do you know which one to use?
So the best way to explain that is that this order, they use both, because they gave us this Julian calendar, which is what, you know, December is 10 in the Julian calendar, and that's what it used to be. And they made this Gregorian calendar around the time of this modern English. And it goes back to what I was explaining earlier with how they synced it all up, the Gregorian calendar, the gematria. And you see how the date numerology and the gematria all work hand in hand. That's why we have this new calendar. It's really the calendar of the New World Order. But they will do rituals in accordance to the Julian calendar. They've done it so many times, like September something, they'll pay attention, they'll treat September as 7 and then the day. And there's been we've documented them doing this as well. So to answer the question, they simply just do both. But, you know, it depends on what pertains to the ritual. Like December 10th is 10/10 in the Julian calendar. Revelation equals 10/10 in the Jewish cipher. So they could pay nod to that. But the fact that it is also 12/1, which is in their calendar as well, they know that. Everyone knows that as well, in terms of it's a, you know, when I say everyone knows that, it's a calendar that we're operating off of. So they pay attention to that and pay tribute to the 12/10. So I hope that wasn't confusing, but yeah, long story short, they use both calendars in their coding.
All right. Well, you got a big fan. I'm going to bet if Sandra is not already subscribed, she will be by the end of the night. She keeps asking a lot of questions, and that's fine, Sandra. Keep them coming. So Sandra wants to know, care to ask him about the last methods on Gematronator where 20 of 2019 is ignored. I hope that you know what that means.
The last methods in Gematronator were 20 of 2019. I'm not too sure about what she means by that. If she means like any other ciphers, she means, or
maybe by last. If I'm not mistaken, Sandra is in Brazil, and so again, English is her second language.
Okay.
So care to ask him about the last methods on Gematronator where 20 of 2019 is ignored. So by last methods, maybe she means one of the older or actually the newer ciphers. So Sandra, if we didn't get your question correctly, maybe rephrase it.
Oh, I think I get it now. I was thinking, so 20 of 20. So I think she means in the date numerology, we have October 11th, 2019. Why ignore the 20 during the date numerology? Because today has a date with 40 numerology, 10 plus 11 plus 19, 40. So I think she's wondering why ignore the 20 of the 2019. And that's just because it's a common way to represent the date. All around the world, you can write the date, month slash day slash the two digits of the year. And how we know it's valid, again, is just repeating, doing this again and again and again. You see how, I'm trying to remember September 11th. Well, that was 21 numerology, but pretty much it's a pattern that they've used so many times. 9 plus 11 plus, and it's always, it goes back to just logical. Like it's a way to represent the date. If I was doing, 9 plus 11 plus 20 plus 10, or I don't even, it's hard to explain with this, but like if I was trying to like make it in a way that didn't really make sense and to make things work, sure. But I'm just going with how we all have been writing the dates in a fashion. So that's why we dropped the 20. It's just a different configuration. Although, like, I know Zachary K. Hubbard, he does a lot of sports decodes. And I've noticed in his sports decodes, like, I think this type of numerology and the life lesson number are, like, the more important ones. So they pay more significance to other ciphers when they're coding certain things. But that doesn't mean they exclude this one.
Okay. Yeah, Sandra said, tell him that that you got it. Can you make predictions with this?
You can. I've on my channel, I've done it countless times. They're all like smaller time predictions, like tomorrow.
Laz. Hey, Laz. Good to see you, buddy. Laz typed it just as I was saying it.
Nice.
So, that's good. All right. So talk to me about predictions.
Sure. So the predictions, the easiest way I do them are just using the date numerology. I mean, I can even predict. See, by prediction, it's really just reading the script. So all I got to do is put in tomorrow's date numerology. I can already tell you Donald Trump's going to be the focus. And the only reason I hate those predictions is because Donald Trump, he is the focus pretty much a lot. So it's kind of hard to like get people on that. But I'm just going to be honest, he is, because it's Saturday and it's October 12th. And I'll explain Donald reversing the alphabetical order equals 112. A lot like October 12, 10 slash 12, 112. So Donald equals 112. It's going to be 112, essentially, because he dropped a zero on a Saturday. That because it's Saturn. Donald Trump, all about Saturn. Donald Trump's campaign lasted from, he announced it June 16th, 2015. And election day was November 8th, 2016. 511 days. In the Jewish cipher, Saturn equals 511.
Amy, do you have influence on Hangouts or Skype? Do you have Hangouts?
Let me see.
I don't want to open it because I'm, OBS is sharing my whole screen, and so I want to keep, those conversations private. So I'd like to.
I do have her on Skype, but
I should.
I don't have her on Hangouts.
I should have gave her the link before I fired up the live stream. But in fact, there might be something in there that she might not want to share if I open up her or my conversation with her. You don't have her on Hangouts?
Gandalf, do you have influence? I don't have her on Hangouts.
Gandalf, do you have influence? You got influence on Hangouts, don't you?
Is he there?
Is Gandalf still alive? Anyway, if influence... I haven't seen her in the live chat, so she may not be around right now, or she may certainly not hanging around here. She might be busy doing something else. But I'll check. We'll check later. Next time Gandalf comes in, we'll ask him. Hey, fellow man's in the chat. Fellow man, do me a favor. Go over to the group hangout and see what Influence is up to and see if she wants to come in here. Or if she feels like hanging out with us for a bit, if she's not busy. Do me that favor, fellow man. Go ahead, Chigozie. I didn't mean to cut you off. Sorry.
Oh, no problem. So tomorrow is about Donald Trump because Donald equals 112. It's on a Saturday. Saturn equals 511 in the Jewish cipher. Saturn also equals 93. The lemma that caught religion, they honor the number 93. Donald Trump's from where? From New York. 39, the reflection of 93. As we've noticed, the Knesset in Israel, like their government, their, that equals 93. There's... Thing with Donald Trump and his attorney encoding, he's got to see it actively, but on my channel, I have plenty of videos showing you how they code Saturn and Donald Trump. So we're going to see Donald Trump in the front page for sure. But even better, tomorrow's a date with 34 numerology. And since that's the life lesson number, the life path number, you want to focus on that first because they'll have a lot of things centralized around that. And as we noticed, murder equals 34, suicide equals 34, tragedy equals 80. So you can see how they use these again and again and then put together a story. You kind of make your own story. And as you're doing that, you don't have to get so specific. Like I can't specifically, at least from just the date numerology, I can't tell you what specific celebrity would be, you know, murdered or sacrificed unless I've been following that celebrity, actually keeping track of their things, actually knowing what's going to happen. You know what I mean? But you can get a general idea. Very well, celebrity murder, killing 43, murder 34, tragedy 80. It's on a Saturday too. They like to have a lot of weekend things. And remember what we were talking about earlier, December 10th, how that was a blood sacrifice day. Tomorrow is 12/10, another 12/10, just like December 10th. Blood sacrifice equals 121. When we were looking at that earlier, I'll bring that back up. We still have it. 121, like the 12th of October. So it's a very good day for some sort of either shooting tragedy or celebrity sacrifice because we get the 121. It's on a Saturday, so they'll sacrifice them to Saturn or Keeper of Time, which means that whoever's going to die, whatever celebrity is going to be, their name will connect to 93, 42, 21, 69 because those are the base cipher numbers for Saturn. So it's really that. Time equals 61, Saturn or Keeper of Time. So I'm really excited to see, you know, 80 days remaining, 80 is just 8 because you dropped a 0 again. So that connects to 8, connecting to time as well. So it's a really ripe day for a celebrity murder connect to Saturn. And now I'm kind of excited to see what it's going to be. Also, black equals 34, Negro equals 22. So they have some propaganda about some black person on the front page. Something, you know, racial divisive programming, Obama could be coming through. They do these things all the time as well. And then with the 41, that's kind of a wild card because that's the USA equals 41. 41 is the 13th prime number. So they can go a lot with that. They could even talk about the Bushes because we get 43 and 41 date numerology. George W. Bush, the 43rd president. George H.W. Bush, the 41st president. That would be interesting to see them both, you know, talked about tomorrow. So it's always kind of up in the air of like what's going to happen exactly. But you can just see the numbers, find the pairings. And the best way I like to do it is I compare the mutable component with the immutable. So the component that each year it will be different. Like October 12, 2020. Notice that the date numerology changes. The life lesson number completely changes. It's not like an incremented because you're now adding 20 to the mix, so the zeros just change the math. But it'll still be the 80th day of the year. But now do you see how next year they compare 80 with, you know, 44 and 62? I can already tell you this can be a sacrifice day, sacrifice 62, kill 44, Saturn 42. I mean, they're going to do the same thing next year. But it'll be different themed. Like, and here's an exercise. You can go last year and see what they did. It was stuff probably by the number 33, could have been a skull and bones ritual, etc. So that's kind of how you predict what's going to happen, by looking at the date numerology, how they're pairing it, and what they've done in the past.
All right, so my friend, our dear friend, Influence Freedom is here, so I'll introduce you. Chigozie, say hello, and Influence, welcome.
Hey, Influence. Glad you're here.
I'm sorry. I wasn't following along because I was off taking care of some things. What's up?
Oh, not much. I'm glad you can make it. I'm just teaching Gematria, showing how the powers that should not be, so mainly this Masonic network, the Freemasons, the...
Oh, no, I know about Gematria. I'm sorry, forgive me, what's your name?
Oh, my name is Chigozie.
Chigozie? Okay, hi, how are you?
I'm fine.
Good. So you guys are going over Gematria. Right. Okay, yeah. Cool.
Influence, when I was reviewing some of his videos earlier today, he mentioned something in one of his videos where he sort of threw a question out to his audience, people who do anagrams, and that was one of the reasons I wanted to get you in here
to
share some of your anagram stuff, because yep. It's really awesome stuff.
Oh, okay. Are you into anagrams?
I am. I guess it's something that I haven't put too much studying into, but I definitely know the power of them, and I know how the media uses them all the time, and they code things with them and whatnot.
Okay, so here's a really wild anagram. Independence
mm-hmm.
is ended in Pence. And that's our vice president right now is Pence. Angry Democrats. I don't know if you've noticed that Trump keeps focusing on the angry Democrats. First it was the 13 angry Democrats. Then it was the 18 angry Democrats. And he's like been tweeting about it. And then yesterday in his rally, he mentioned it again. And angry Democrats is an anagram of Macron's tragedy, which is the president of France, which was really interesting with all the stuff happening in France and Notre Dame and stuff.
Yeah.
Wow. Nation is an anagram of anoint.
Do you want to share your screen or do you just want to go over it any way you want? You had that whole list that was...
The only thing is right now I'm rendering that animation. So I'm like 150 pictures in and I really don't want to
overload your
stress the computer
CPU.
With okay. more sharing a screen.
Sure.
If that's cool.
That's fine.
Hopefully you can write them down. Write them down because I'm going to give you some good ones.
All right.
Well, Chigozie, you got open up a notepad or something because you can type
type
crazy, crazy fast, and I couldn't possibly write that fast.
Whoops, sorry. Because even if I share my screen, you still won't have them.
Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. And by the way, I didn't want to send you the link in the Hangouts because I didn't. I'm sharing my OBS is sharing my whole screen. I didn't want to.
I gotcha. Yeah. Cool. All right, so, nation is an anagram of anoint. And climate change is an anagram of chemical agent. Cancel mega hit. Hit angel mecca. Thence magical. That one's really fucking crazy. So I'm going to reread those again, okay? So climate change is mm-hmm. an anagram of chemical agent.
Mm-hmm.
Thence magical. Cancel mega hit. Hit angel mecca. Mecca hating L.
Mecca hating L. Ooh.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. That I was gonna say. That sounds.
They're
pretty...
all crazy. Climate change is like this crazy
ooh,
power.
That's a wow. That's a head turner on that one.
Yeah.
Mecca hating L. Because we know L is a Jewish.
Yeah.
God.
And why cancel mm-hmm. mega hit?
And Mecca. We know Mecca.
Hit
Muslim
angel Mecca.
Wow.
That's pretty intense.
And thence magical.
Wow.
Yeah. And chemical agent.
Yeah, I like the chemical agent.
They're all fucking crazy, right? Okay.
Yeah, they really are.
All right. So, you know the movie It? And you know how it's all about the echo. And the clown keeps telling them to come home. So in the new ones, right?
Mm-hmm.
The clown keeps telling those kids that are now older to come home. Well, come home is an anagram of echo memo.
Mm.
And the movie's all about an echo. And then it shows I heart dairy because it's got the little I in the heart. And that's an anagram for retire Hydra.
And if you don't know, Chigozie, Hydra is
a constellation.
It's a major constellation.
Besides the Avengers and all that other stuff.
Yeah.
But that's all based on the stars anyway, so.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Okay, let's see. Oh, here's a funny one. First man on the moon. Oh, no, not firmaments.
That's amazing.
Oh, the flat earth gets into everything, don't it?
Oh, Lanny's gonna like that one.
Reincarnation can retrain ion, nor can inertia train in cornea, error in inaction. Those are kind of wild ones. September 11th, sheep tremble event. Tell me if I'm too close to my mic, you guys.
No, you're fine. We love your voice anyway. Louder the better.
September 11th is sheep tremble event.
Wow.
Stars and stripes, Spartan distress. And Spartans, the culture centered on the loyalty to the state and military service, and that's us, the military country.
Yep.
And that's Spartan distress. Okay, now I'm going to say some here that, listen, these are just anagrams.
Yeah, this is not coming. The views of our guests may or may not represent the views of the host.
Okay. Synagogue. Gas one guy. Us gone gay.
Whoa.
Young ages.
Whoa.
And hold on, there's a agent's goofy anus. Okay, this is Synagogue of Satan. Okay, this is Synagogue of Satan. A agent's goofy anus. A sus faggot, anyone?
A sus faggot?
Yeah, a sus faggot, anyone?
Wow.
Okay, so here's a really messed up one. Star religions, sorting Israel.
Damn, that's a home runner on that one.
Garlic festival, the Santiago William Legan guy. His name is an anagram of, well, I gag nationalism. And remember, he wrote that that memo that they were saying was all like nationalists and stuff.
What was that?
That was the shooter from the garlic festival, Santiago William Legan. And he had that manifesto. His name is, well, I gag nationalism.
Wow.
Serpent repents and presents. Here's a good one. Mary Magdalene, anagram medley.
Wow.
Her name is actually anagram medley. Yep. My agenda realm.
My agenda realm is Mary Magdalene.
Yep.
Wow.
Speaking of Mary Magdalene, before we get too far and I forget, I was watching Chigozie video earlier, and he mentioned something. He was talking about Washington, D.C., and how its location is parked right on the border between Virginia and Maryland.
Mm-hmm.
And Maryland is Maryland, It's right between Virginia, Virgin, and Mary.
Yep.
Yep.
So do you remember, Influence, I was talking to you about a project where I wanted to see if we could overlay the constellation star map onto like a world map or a United States map or a particular country or perhaps the whole world and see if city locations line up with particular star locations.
So yeah, you're going to have to know exactly when, where, and what.
Well,
where
I know. I think I might have a clue where to begin. And it was watching Chigozie's video where he reminded me that Maryland and Virginia are, you know, where D.C. is located. But maybe that's a good starting point. It's worth a try. So now I got something to work on this weekend.
Okay. Jesus of Nazareth. I'll leave that one alone. Because there's some weird ones in there.
I bet.
Okay. Bethlehem, be the helm, which is interesting when you think about the ship Argo and the flood and everything. Okay. Kanye Omari West, Story Week Mania, Monkey It's Aware. That's just fucked up. Stormy Daniels, Listed Masonry, Deny Moralists, Twin Towers, Two Went, Sir.
Oh, a fellow man just said in the chat, he said, Rosemary's Baby is all of them witches. Wait a minute. No, that's not an anagram. What are you talking about?
Rosemary's Baby doesn't have any W.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, I just read it real quick. I was like, wait a minute. What are you talking about, fella man? What? But he's got all of them witches in quotations. What do you mean, fella man? Go ahead, you guys. Sorry.
Okay, so Lois Lane is Soul Alien, which is S-O-L, Soul, S-O-L. Soul Alien, and Superman is an anagram of a new sperm, A-N-U, sperm. And a new is the supreme sky god.
Anu sperm.
Yeah, Anu sperm and Soul Alien. Wonder Woman is, Roman End or Woman or Wand. Draw Omen Now. The End is Nigh. He Hint Design. And I think this one's funny. End in Shit, eh?
That's a good one.
I just thought that was funny. End in Shit, eh? Oh, the Fox News guy, Pete Hegseth. His name is Get the Sheep.
Wow.
Tommy Lauren, the blonde chick that everybody knows from the Fox. So-called alt-right or whatever. Lit Menorah.
Wow.
Brian Kilmeade, a real embed kin, a media blinker. Lancer Jones, Clan Jew in Rose. Ainsley Earhart, a starry headline. Steve Ducey, So Ye TV Code. Diamond and Silk, I think, is interesting because if you just put diamond with silk, like this diamond silk, it's Amid Dawn Ilks, Made Dawn Silk, Sink Damn Idol. Shannon Bream, Bands Menorah. Tucker Carlson, Rectal, Uncorks Rectal. And Shepard Smith is Had Shit Sperm.
Oh, wow.
So those are some funny ones.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. I really get into anagrams. It's really amazing what a lot of people's will reveal. Andrew Breitbart, rabbi went retard.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. So if you're following the damn stuff at all, DreamWorks, the movie company, is an anagram of damn workers.
And isn't there, I know that one of their logos is some dude fishing. I don't know. It's one of, like, that's like one of their things they had.
Oh, and here's another one. Mosioc is an anagram of, oh, I scam. Hmm. Yeah. And his coma. Yeah, people are in a coma, right? We can't remember shit of our old ancient past.
Well, I think they hide it from us. Radically.
Yeah. Now, here's one more. I'm going to end with revolution. Okay, so revolution is really wild because on one side of it, it's love. On the other side, it's evil. Mm. So here's anagrams for revolution. I run to love or to unveil. Run to evil, evil on tour, love in tour, to ruin love, lit our oven.
Hmm.
Yeah, so it's either love or evil with revolution.
Incredible.
That's very, that's incredible for sure. That's really good work. The stuff is really cool. I really like anagrams.
Yeah, anagrams are very interesting. And you can tell, like, with some of them that they are actually meant to be anagrams.
Oh, yeah.
Like the Lois Lane and Superman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you know, there that reminds me, there's one anagram that, to me, I found hilarious, absolutely hilarious and profound. And it is absolutely intentional. It's nothing mainstream. I don't know if you or anybody in my audience know who Kent Hovind is. He's a religious apologist. And his son, Eric Hovind, is following in daddy's footsteps. And they run a TV show and ministry and whatever. So Eric Hovind, there's a YouTube channel called Viced Rhino who takes the piss out of religious people, particularly like young earth creationists, okay? And his YouTube channel is dedicated to stuff like evolution, the biology and the science behind evolution, and just generally correcting all the errors that these guys spout in their online and whatever TV, radio broadcasts. And this channel is called Viced Rhino, and he's got, you know, a little cartoon rhino as an icon. But Viced Rhino is an actual anagram for Eric Hovind. And he did that on purpose. It's hilarious. I think it's just, I'm sorry. Didn't mean to interrupt your flow, but I just found that to be pretty, it was, I know, it's intentional and it's pretty hilarious.
Right? I'm reading some of the ones like, somebody put one for fellow man's name. That was funny. Fellow man lies is evil woman fell.
Do you have a favorite anagram site?
Oh yeah, Wordsmith.
Wordsmith?
Yeah, hold on. I'll grab it. I'll put it in the thing for you guys.
Thanks. Is it .org, I presume?
Hold on, let me see.
Killendale said he thinks what's more interesting, he thinks, than anagrams is breaking down the meaning of letters, like people break down the meaning of numbers.
Oh, yeah, breaking down the meaning of the letters is good. But you know what? There was a guy online, and he was trying to say that the letters and the numbers represented the angles within the corners of that. But I was able to prove them wrong by number 4, 5, 6, 7. Like, I don't even understand how he got up in front of a college and made that presentation. I was very perplexed because what he was saying was flat out absolutely provable right in front of his face, not true. But they are studying the how a number or a letter came to be is really interesting, for sure. Hold on, I'm just grabbing that link. Okay, I put it in there for you guys. It's wordsmith.org/anagram/index. Now it'll only handle so many characters, you know?
So you couldn't put in a paragraph.
Oh God, no. You might be able to get in 3 medium to short words.
Right.
Like so Mary Magdalene, or maybe your whole name if your name's not like 26 letters long of the alphabet or something.
Yes. Gotcha. That's awesome.
But the independence one really freaks me out, I gotta be honest. That one freaks me out.
That is... some of them were...
Say it again. I had to walk away for a second. What is independence?
Ended in pence.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah. That one's almost kind of sends chills up your spine.
Right. And then the Macron's tragedy one. The angry Democrats. Like, he's really focused on this phrase. And when it came up right away, Macron's tragedy, I'm like, really? Seriously? But you know what? Here's what's really crazy. Mm-hmm. Also, is that my grandfather was shot and murdered by a hitchhike, by these 2 hitchhikers. It was a big news story back in the 50s. And anyways... the way that they caught the killer was when my grandfather, when they tried to pull him out of the car and he fought him off, he ripped the button off of the kid's shirt. And when he ripped the button off of the kid's shirt, he died with the button in his hand. Okay. And that's how they caught these kids, was because they busted them at this motel and found the kid with the missing shirt button that was in my grandpa's hand. So my name actually has add a gunman shirt. Okay, honor, add a gunman shirt.
Wow. Now,
So that's really trippy, but it isn't just... trippy. Yeah, and what's also really trippy is that he was killed in a Mercury... and I was born with the planet Mercury. He died hours before the spring equinox. I was born hours before the fall equinox. He died with exactly $69 on him, and I was born in 1969. And then my name is an anagram of the event that ended his life and captured the killers. It's really trippy shit.
Wow. Oh,
That's so insane. That just shows, I think the anagrams have so much power, and like that example right there, just, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Some of them are just crazy.
Some of them are absolutely head turners.
Yeah. Like that one.
And I just am like building a list of crazy ones, and sometimes I'll just totally get lost in anagrams for like an hour or whatever. Like I did all the Fox people from Fox News. I did all the hosts.
I'm gonna have to play around with them for sure.
So Chigozie, have you ever played around with Gematronator and just dropped in like random stuff like YouTube or Google? What do they show? What kind of gematria numbers come up with those kind of inputs?
So I've definitely dropped those in. I've spent so much time. I can do every single day. Like whatever comes to mind, I'll put in. YouTube and Google are very interesting. So tragedy equals 35. So does YouTube. 35, 28, and 80. YouTube is a tragedy, but in more so, they're going for, well, you know, for example, tomorrow you can expect YouTube, it's possible YouTube could be in the propaganda media with some sort of story, something, it's possible. But Thelema equals 28 and 35, going back to that. So they put the numbers for Thelema, Israel, 28, that Thelema, Israel, Zion pattern is used in YouTube as well. And we know them both, you know, Jewish-run corporations, Google, 61. So tomorrow there was 61 numerology. We could get Google and YouTube, which is run by the same gang. Jewish equals 34 as well, life lesson number 34. We could see them tomorrow based on that pattern. Google equals 34 and 61. I really started to think we could see Google in some CNN front page. This is a pretty good pairing, 61, 34. And that's just really how I predict what's going to happen. I mean, these people are so repetitive that, like, the last time it was the day with 61 numerology, Google was on the front page. So that's why I'm saying they could possibly do it again. So, and for more explanation, why is Google equals 61? Because that's the God number. Jesus equals 61. Church equals 61. And then God in the Jewish cipher equals 61. And this is a good way. It shows how they use these bigger ciphers. So if anyone's new to the, I know people probably drop inside the live stream, but what we're doing here is Gematria. C is the third letter. H is the eighth. U is the 21st. You just add those all, you get 61. And then God in the Jewish cipher, which is based on the Latin alphabet. So you see how A through I is 9, and then you, instead of K11, you do K is 10, and you go 20, you count by 10s, and then S is 9, and then you go to hundreds, and then you go up to W is 900. So it's still like an organized cipher, and that gives you 61. And then church, 61, you use the alphabetical order. Like, yeah.
Hang on right there with church. What do we have? 61, 34, 101, 29. Now throw in Kirk, okay, like Captain Kirk, because if I'm not mistaken, the word Kirk is, it's a, I think it's German or I forget, if it's not German, it's some other language, but it means church. The word Kirk, Captain Kirk, actually means church. The word Kirk means church. So I just, okay. I just wanted to see, so there's a 109, is that, so... Let me see. 49, 22, 59. There's a 109. Wasn't there a 109 in church?
No, church was 29. 109 is the 29th prime number. So 109, it connects to 29. That's the 109 is the 29th prime number. So that's very interesting.
Now I feel like I'm reaching because nothing's like really jumping out big time. I just wanted to see.
So it's good you pointed out, and I think it's a good time to emphasize these primary relationships because they do this all the time. If they want to link 29 to something, they'll use 109 to link that. And that's why I'm finding this very interesting how in the Jewish cipher it equals 109 to 29th prime, and then church equals 29. And then we go back to things like prophecy.
Try Iglesia.
Iglesia. Equals 35, 46, like Catholic. These are numbers for the Catholic Church. Catholic, 35, 46, like Iglesia. That's so interesting. 35, 46. So church doesn't have that, but, you know, as the language has changed, the Gematria definitely will change. But church still goes with a God pattern. God equals 26. Church equals 101, the 26th prime number. So...
I had one question. Now, are these words that you place into the Gematria calculator, mm-hmm. is it based off of the word itself, or is it some kind of like number value of the separate letters in the word itself?
I think so. These numbers are, if I heard you correctly, like the numbers here are kind of based on the word, but like inside the words, like there's different groupings of letters that like I pay more attention to. I mean, all this kind of answers your question, like Jerusalem with the USA in the middle, USA founded with 32, 104 numerology, July 4th, 1776. Whoops, I did 14th. 32-104. So it's this type of pairing, paired with the USA in the middle, Jerusalem. There's a significance there, but then the word itself is very significant. Like, these words are kind of crafted to kind of, not kind of, but to fit these patterns. Like, they wanted Jesus and Messiah equals 74. Is there maybe the ME or something? Is there a significance behind that? You know, we call ourselves me, Messiah. If there's some, is there some riddle behind that? Quite possibly. But just on like this level of this, the, how the numbers are working out, they're just kind of matching the words. I don't know if that answers your question.
No, that does kind of answer it. Like, I've just been sitting here listening, man. It's pretty fascinating. I'm starting to kind of get a grasp of this.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I'm really happy to hear that. And that's why I continue, every time I see these good examples, I like to just make videos on them, because the more examples I document, the more resonates we can see. You know, President Trump speaks at a campaign rally in Lake Charles, Louisiana. It depends on what it's about, but what I like to do is when I see these things, I'll see how many days from their birthday they're doing it. Donald Trump's born on Flag Day, the Army's birthday, June 14th. So from his current birthday till today, we can see 119 days. Donald equals 119. And not only that, before we do that, remember earlier I was saying Donald Trump's coded with Saturn all the time, the numbers are Saturn, keeper of time, and that it's good to see. You're going to have to apply this and see a lot of examples and how they're always putting numbers to Saturn, Donald Trump, to fully get the pattern, because it's more of an occult, obscure kind of thing. And they're doing it here in the Francis Bacon cipher, where you take into account the capital letters, Saturn equals 119. So yep. 119 days from his birthday, he's here in some big ritual, and Donald in the Jewish cipher equals 119. And he won the presidential election on the... So the election was November 8th, but it went to the early morning, like 2 a.m. or something. So he won on 11/9, the 11th or November 9th. So
And what is that if you use the European calendar? 9/11.
Oh, yes. 9 or...
Yeah, I mean, it would be 11/9, but then swap it to our calendar, it's 9/11.
11, yes. 9/11.
Reversal, 9/11. So I thought I was the only one seeing that. I was like, what the fuck is going on?
I love it. Can you type that?
Donald Trump becoming president on 9/11, and then people are still like, oh, it's all coincidence. It's like, that's just...
Can you put in Jupiter?
Yeah, you know what? I was going to do that. I was going to go there, influence. I was waiting for...
I just want to see it. Can you put Jupiter?
Yeah, what's Jupiter? And I'm so glad she asked that. I've been waiting to ask this question, and this is another reason I wanted her to come on. Because in many of your videos, you show and talk about how Saturn is associated with the number 42. But 42 is the alchemical symbol for Jupiter.
Well, that's super interesting, because Jupiter equals 45. Donald Trump's the 45th president. And Jupiter, this pattern I see here, connects to the sun. Like, sun equals 9. Very interesting. So that's how the 42 connects. So it all makes sense now, for sure. And, you know, that's why Donald Trump's born in June. Like, Jupiter, June.
He's born June 14th.
Mm-hmm. 1946. We can see his birth numerology real quick, too. Born date with 31 numerology. Donald equals 31. Reversing and reducing. Donald 31. Born date with 31 numerology. Born on the 165th day of the year. Scottish Rite 165. Federal government 85. He's the head of the federal government. You know, the narrative, of course.
Zora Dax says Jupiter is 119 KFW Kabbalah.
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, so they have Kabbalah ciphers as well. They're based in the ordering of, so a lot of it's based on, like, for example, Aleister Crowley, his book, The Liber Ale Legis.
Oh, look at 72 in Kabbalah also.
Wow.
119 in Kabbalah.
Yeah, like Donald, like 119.
Look at all the 36s.
36.
Wow. Well, so for these, the reason these repeat is because this calculates if there's a K or a V. And
right.
Say, you know, are we going to reduce it or not? So since there's no K or V and there's no S in Jupiter, these are just a copy of this. So it's still just like 136.
Yeah. See, I'm not following Saturn. I'm like following Jupiter. A lot of people are oh, there was 42 down at the bottom.
Oh, right, wow. Nice.
Keypad. Yeah,
the keypad. So like on the phone, the way they have the numbers arranged on the phone. And you can check out Zenith of the Alpha America, his channel. He's a really good researcher and decoder. And he shows how they use the keypad cipher like on your phone to decode a lot of things. And now yeah. Jupiter's used to connect to 42 is really interesting.
Yeah. Well, Jupiter's the king of kings and Saturn was defeated. So I'm just not sure why I guess they're invested in Saturn, but they're really invested in Jupiter. I mean, all these temples and churches are built on Jupiter temples.
Absolutely. And that's, I'm glad you brought that point up too. That's something they're really into as well. Especially even like with the Jupiter probe mission in July 4th, that was a big Jupiter ritual. They have Jupiter in the front page CNN quite often. There's been a lot of Jupiter rituals these past couple months in June and July, I remember. So yeah. That's super true.
And Jupiter takes 12 years to get through the signs almost.
Hmm.
So it's also a really good timekeeper because of how long it takes to get through the 12 zodiac is almost 12 years.
That's perfect. Yeah, 12, that number for completion as well. That makes so much sense.
Speaking of rituals, I'm sorry to interrupt your flow. There's another question in the chat. Can we speak, please? Someone's asked, Sampa Views, can we please speak about eclipse, sun, moon rituals? Eclipses, yeah. And sun, moon rituals.
Yes, we can. And it's funny that they asked that because Donald Trump's always using these eclipse, sun, Saturn rituals as well. So we've kind of been on that page, but definitely love to talk more about it.
Yeah, so, he was born during the lunar eclipse, right?
Mm-hmm.
And wait. Trump was born on a lunar eclipse?
Yeah, Trump was born under a lunar eclipse, and his mother's name is Mary, and his father's and his grandma's name has Christ, and so does his father.
Can anybody hear me now?
Yeah, we hear you.
I had to drop out. I wanted to point out something. I was trying to point out something.
Let me just finish this last sentence. Yeah, and then the guy that's trying to take Trump down, this whole Adam shifting with Adam leading the committee against him, his wife's name is Eve.
While we're talking about the Jupiter, and you were talking about the 12 months, I noticed that in the Jewish reduction, we have that 37, which is an interesting number. When you multiply it by multiples of three, things are interesting, but that's something else. It is the 12th prime number.
Ah, nice.
That is interesting.
So I was you were going the 12th, and I'm trying to say, hey, you got that 12th prime number there. And nobody could hear me, so I dropped out and came back in.
Mark, if you type in 6/14/1946 lunar eclipse, it'll give you where it was. I don't think it was in North America. It might have been somewhere else, but there was a lunar eclipse that day.
Lunar eclipse equals 72 as well. It's really interesting. And 54 like Sun. And lunar equals 21 like Saturn. They put 21 on Trump all the time. And it all goes up to this as well.
Mark T in the chat just said 6/14/1946. That's Trump's birthday? 6/14/1946?
Yes, I'll bring him up.
Mark T in the chat just said that he just checked again, and 6/14/1946 was 100% full moon.
Yeah, look up lunar eclipse 6/14/1946.
Okay.
Oh, not you. I mean him. Mark in the Google
in the chat
search.
If I'm not mistaken, don't we usually, let me see, in order for a lunar eclipse to occur, it's going to naturally be a full moon, isn't it?
It has to be.
It does have to be, because of the planetary mechanics. That's sort of how it has to happen.
Yeah, but I wanted him to see where the lunar eclipse was.
Okay.
Because I'm pretty sure it wasn't in America, but it definitely, there was the lunar eclipse was happening. See, once you start to get a feel for the constellations, what's really funny is then you got to get wrapped up into the asterisms. Oh, then there's another whole thing going on. And then when you get through the asterisms, and then you got to start learning all the meteor showers to understand how they use that, and then you think you start getting through that, and then you start realizing the more, like, and I'm just realizing some of this tonight even, is that they have, like, these whole story structures between these certain stars and certain assignments. And I was like, let me tell you what I mean, if I can find it. Hold on.
You know, if there's a third reason I wanted you in here, Influence. Chigozie, on one of his videos this past week or so, we had this Amanda Geiger, what's her first name, did I screw that up?
Amber Geiger.
Amber.
Yes.
Amber Geiger. So first it's Amber, right, which is
like an alert
or yeah, or the color of a flame or an explosion, and Geiger as in Geiger counter, which I found her straight up name without any anagrams or anything to be pretty interesting. But Chigozie did a video on the witness who was murdered, who was shot dead outside of his house. This black guy who was, he was wearing a Dragon Ball Z t-shirt.
Oh, yeah. That's Dragon
Ball
Z.
And this all just happened this past week. And there have been tons of dragon symbolism in media the past couple of days or a week or so.
Wow.
And just, what was it, 3 days ago, Influence, was it 3 or 4 days ago, we just had the meteor shower, and it was the this meteor shower that came from the constellation Draco.
Yeah, Draconids.
Draconids.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, it was just this past week, this meteor shower came from the location of the constellation Draco, called the draft,
like the cosmos, and every time I see wherever you guys are talking about or him putting out, I just can't help but think, like, I know I'm missing such a giant chunk to what they're doing, because I know that a lot of what they're doing is based on exactly that, like the constellations and stuff like that, astrotheology, and I'm trying to know more about that piece to really get it all together.
Now, one of these days soon, Influence and I are going to do like an introduction. We're going to do like a whole show, which is going to be just an introduction a ground level up to the stuff that her and I talk about, because I know that when she presents her screen and shares her Stellarium program and her and I get deep into conversation, that it's kind of like what I was telling you earlier about new people coming to your channel. You know, you talk real fast and you have a lot to say, and it just flies over the heads of new people. So we're going to do an introductory show on astrotheology one of these days soon.
Mark said it was over the Orient. Thanks, Mark. Yeah, I knew it wasn't in America, but I knew there was a lunar eclipse at his birth. Trump has been absolutely designed for all of this.
Mm-hmm.
There's no doubt. Like, I couldn't even believe that people who follow all this, I couldn't even believe they thought Hillary would win. I was like, everything tells you in all the programming for decades who is going to win. They show us Trump when he's 33 in his real like sit down interview. Then he's 42 when Oprah interviews him and asks him if he'd run for president.
Wow.
And then all of his marriages and divorces and his life was put before our eyes so that we would all be invested in his life. You know, the 40 to 50 year olds, you know, we all grew up with his divorce from Ivana and his remarriage and his divorce again. And then, not to mention everybody following Apprentice.
Yeah, I was going to say, throw the Apprentice in, Gematronator.
Oh, the Apprentice, that's a really good one. The Apprentice equals 211. That's the 47th prime number. Trump equals 47. President equals 47. Also equals 67, like Freemasonry. It also equals 68, like Donald Trump and Donald John Trump. Or excuse me, Donald J. Trump. So Donald J. Trump equals 68, reversing and reducing. Donald John Trump equals 68 with the full reduction. So they both equal 68. And then the Apprentice equals 68. And it's with 68 numerology, you get Donald Trump propaganda all the time. And again, the Apprentice 211 to 47 prime. 47 is the number for Trump and the number for president. Number for authority as well. Number for government, for White House, for official, etc. For DC, 47. So these presidential examples are pretty good. And one quick thing I saw here is Forbes estimated his net worth to be $3.1 billion. And we just saw how Donald Trump was born today with 31 numerology, 6 plus 1 plus 4 plus 1 plus 9 plus 4 plus 6. That's 31. They're saying $3.1 billion because Donald equals 31, reversing and reducing. So
can you look up Mike Pence?
Oh, absolutely. You'll love Mike Pence.
And independence.
Mike Pence.
Compare that to
independence. Independence equals
curiosity.
So independence equals 226, 55, 62, and 98. Sacrifice equals 62 and 55. And that's pretty interesting. 98, like Israel. That's why they named their Zionist, quote unquote, independent state Israel, okay, which equals 98.
So what was Mike Pence? I missed it. You were pretty quick.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
That's okay. 81.
81, 45. Okay. And he's the vice president.
For the 45th, yeah.
And they even emphasize that by in the reverse full reduction and right, the full reduction, making that 45. So it's very crazy how the hell they did that. I want to see what Pence alone equals. Oh, 92, 25. Trump equals 29 and 25, like Pence.
Well, you know that Pence is also a Gemini. They are both Geminis.
Oh, that's true.
Right. So if you were to read it in scripture, we're dealing with the two witnesses.
Or the two thieves, or the twins.
That's interesting.
And it's, I like that.
I meant in relation to Revelations.
The two witnesses. Okay, gotcha. Yeah.
Castor and Pollux, the twins.
Those two are always used in so many Revelation coding as well. So that's, to me, it makes perfect sense.
Well, Christ, that's where, well, Christ, well,
because
Christ
here's
was crucified
what's really
between
funny
two thieves.
Is Donald, okay, so they're the twins, and then you've got Adam, Schiff, Adam coming after him, and Adam's married to Eve, and then we have Hunter Biden, which Biden rhymes with Orion, Ian and Biden, right? Ian, yeah. Ian, yeah. Okay, and then Hunter, which Orion is the hunter, right?
Yeah.
And everybody right now in the audience yesterday when he was doing his rally was going, "Where's Hunter? Where's Hunter?" And the whole this narrative is literally sitting on the Milky Way on the horizon together. All these characters, and including Stormy Daniels, the tribe of Dan, right? Like they're all hanging out. This whole fucking star story is like literally just staring us in the face on the television too. And I'm like, you guys are real. This is like, but at the same time, if it isn't by design and it's truly just the way it is, then that's crazy too. Like it's all crazy,
no matter how you look at it.
Yeah, it's definitely completely crazy. And I like how with this Gematria element, when you see this, and then you just see how they're always doing these star rituals as well.
Oh, the star rituals is everything. Oh, hey, rhinoceros. I just want to say hi to Rhino in the...
Rhino gets a wrench.
And I just want to say Victor Schauberger to Rhino.
Ah, Victor Schauberger.
Victor Schauberger. Okay. All right.
I keep winding up being
muted somehow.
Yeah, I don't know why.
You keep dropping out.
Yep. I start talking and nobody responds, and it's like I'm.
We just don't care about you.
I know. That's really what it is.
I always like saying hi to Rhino.
Rhino's good dude.
Nice.
Okay, so let me see. Let me go back to some of my notes. Maybe I might have overlooked a question or so. Cover the Dragon Ball. Seattle, what do you think about this? Seattle is back in focus. Okay, that's a good question. Let's talk about Seattle for a minute, because there's a lot of people making predictions about an event in Seattle.
Yeah, can you type in Seattle?
Yeah, so Seattle equals 19, 82,
107, and 44. 82. Okay, 44. Wait a second. Hold on. Okay, 44 is very important. Okay, 82 is very important. Because, of course, you know Trump's thing, too, is 88022. To text him.
Yeah.
So the numbers that were always in front of him on the podium the whole time he was running,
yeah,
was the 88022. Okay, so here's another very interesting thing about when Trump was running. At every single speech, he did this snake story with the woman. Right? Do you know what I'm talking about?
I think I remember that.
I'm not really certain. I know.
Okay, so when he was running for president, at every single rally, he opened up with telling this story of the woman who let in the snake. And then the snake turns on the woman and bites her.
Oh, right. And
all right, so.
Okay, I remember now.
If you go to the movie Casino, and you watch Sharon Stone when she's talking to what's the short guy's name again? I always forget his name.
Pesci.
Joe Pesci, yes. And she says, Gemini, you got to watch out for the Gemini because they're the snake. All right. So if you put the horizon line from the east to the west, you have the twins over in the east setting and you have the snake rising in the west. I mean, in the You got the twin setting in the west, and you've got the snake rising in the east with Ophicus, right? So they're on the opposite of the horizon, and it's the woman, Virgo, including Andromeda, even if you really want to be technical, including Cassiopeia, even up in the north.
The only three women.
Yeah, but Virgo's sitting there, and she lets the snake in, but the twin is down in the east, is over in the east, and the woman's there letting the snake in the west. And of course, the woman's going to die off in the horizon first, because Virgo's going to circle and go around and die off in the west first, and then the snake follows, right? So Trump's literally telling this fucking alignment, even at his own speeches. Like, he's actually telling the snake story right there. And Gemini is the snake because it's the opposite. It's the opposing over there. It's just too much.
It's just, oh my goodness. It's like, once you just see this narrative, it's just one giant drama joke.
It is.
Yes. Yes. It's like they are literally putting on a play for us.
But even if they weren't, and this all is just really happening, it's like the universe is totally a trickster.
Right.
Yeah. Is totally into joking and fucking around with us and playing all the games, and hence why it's in all of us humans and animals to play and goof and troll and laugh.
It's like I said to Jordan Maxwell the other day, last week, that the as above, so below motif is thousands of years old and still relevant today for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, I do believe they're doing things. So
I do too.
Yeah, even though I'm saying the universe, because in my life, I don't feel that I'm part of anything, but somehow my whole life has this weird stuff going on nonstop, and I'm not just making it up. It's just, that's just the way it is. So yeah, if it's like that for my life, then maybe it's like that for theirs too. But fuck that. These people still committed crimes.
I will say this much, you know, as far as my life goes, I mean, there have been a few things, like my chosen name I discovered is, guess what, 47. And, you know, I'm bringing forth a foundation for human society that is, if not a utopia, which I don't think it is, but it's just vastly better than what we have now. And foundation is 47. So I'm like, okay, that's kind of weird. But beyond that, I really haven't seen anything that I can point to and go, oh, look, nifty connection. So I'm looking at things like that vid that you did with all those 52s. When was that, earlier today or yesterday? I don't remember exactly, Chigozie. But, you know, when you have, you know, 5 or 6 or 8 52s all related to the same incident, I can't believe that that was just a natural occurrence. Somebody had to set that up.
Absolutely. And that's how I see it too. Like, I definitely know that the organic layer can be pretty crazy, but it's good when you do apply to yourself. But then when you go to the media and you're like, okay, well, this blows my personal, you know, story way out the water.
Yes.
I put it in place to my life too, but it's never as crisp as it is when you apply it to just the front page or any media in the sports or anything.
I want to say one thing that really, really impresses me is the way that you'll start a lot of your vids by showing the numerology and giving us what we can expect in the news before you've opened the news. And then you open the news, and such a high percentage of the time, you nail it. You know, I mean, and if you don't nail it, you find other connections to the numbers. That's, like, you know, you'll say we'll have a story about Brexit, and then there's Brexit right there in the headline, and I'm like, oh my gosh.
I was wondering if I could run some numbers by you and tell me if there's any significance in this, man.
Oh, sure.
So the top bracket for English ordinal is 96, full reduction 33, reverse ordinal 120, and reverse full reduction 48. And the bottom numbers are 6, 33, 3, and 3.
Okay, well, whatever these numbers you mentioned, the 96, 33, 48, I don't remember the third one in that sequence, 96, but you mentioned 96, 33, 48.
96, 33, 120, 48.
Oh, 120, 48, okay. So those are numbers for the Illuminati and for Freemasonry. That's a very common pattern that they do as well. Like, for example, you'll see something like that on, like, the front page. And, like, something randomly coded. So, a rule of thumb is, like, if you're looking at this, you'll see someone with a shirt that says something on it.
Did he really walk out? Just out of curiosity. Did Shepard Smith just leave Fox today or something?
Yeah, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he had shit sperm anyway, so. Just checking.
But and we even see the patterns in this. But, like, those numbers are numbers for, like, Masonry and for the Illuminati. Freemason equals 96 and 48. Masonry equals 33. And then Illuminati. And the Bavarian Illuminati, you know, they're a Masonic gang as well. So Illuminati equals 120 and 48. So you get this Illuminati Freemasonry numbers. And so let's just say, like, we're going to look at this Fox News guy, we'll get probably numbers for cancel, for remove, you know, death, killing, murder, sacrifice numbers, because he's not really being sacrificed, but it's all, you know, proverbial. He's walking out, he's leaving. So we're probably going to get those numbers. But let's just say, like, we had a story of, you know, this girl made the best, like, science fair project. This is what she did. And they'll have her wear a shirt, they'll say something. It'll most likely have those numbers of, like, Freemasonry, the Illuminati, because it's not something that's super specific that they're going to have, you know, sacrifice numbers on, or the numbers for, like, Israel. It's more of a general thing.
Hey, can you guys hear me? I just had a microphone issue. Can you guys... You can hear me, though? Okay, cool. I came unplugged. I just want to make sure... Thank you. Sorry, I tell you what, guys, I'm going to drop out and I'm going to come back in because everybody's saying there's weird audio, and it might be me because my mic came unplugged and I plugged it back in, so maybe I got something screwed up on my end. Everybody in the chat is saying it's back. It is back. What's back? The bad noise or good audio? It isn't. Sandra's saying it's not you. There has been no sound since you had a mic issues. Okay, I'm gonna shit. Okay, wait. So you can't. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I have no idea what's going on, but I tell you what, I'm going to leave the hangout and I'm going to come right back in just a second, and hopefully that'll clear it up. So see you, bye, and I'll be right back. All right, Amy, you sound better for me at least. You guys let us know if the audio cleared up or got any better or worse or what. Oh, crap. Tix tisk. No, it's still the same, they say. Let me just try again. Let me just leave and come back. It's probably me because I'm the one hosting and my mic came unplugged. Influence left. She'll probably come back. There, she's back. I'm going to leave and come back. Okay. Everybody, give me some feedback. Have we made any improvement? Say what, Gandalf? No, everybody in the chat saying that our audio is fucked up. Well, I don't really want to start a new one. We're already 2 hours and 35 minutes in. Maybe we ought to just go ahead and wrap it up and hope. No, this was fun. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm gonna. Wait. So. All right. So they're saying that they can hear me, everybody in the, I think, right? Only your voice, or is it only my voice that's screwed up? Sandra, somebody. Allison says, now I can hear your voice. All right, real quick, you guys, give me some last-minute feedback. Did it clear up? Are we good to go, or shall we just go ahead and call it a night? Because Josh is going to start his stream. Josh has already started, so we're going to go hang out with Josh. It's been 2 hours and 35 minutes with Chigozie, and you can only hear my voice, and it's crackling. Okay, so, all right, thank you, guys. Thanks, everybody, for being here. Thank Chigozie. And unfortunately, they won't be able to hear you to say thanks for being here. But Chigozie, thank you for a great presentation and a cool show. We had a great turnout, by the way. Thanks, Influence. Yep. We had a really good turnout, man. I was periodically checking the viewership. We had we were up to 45 the last I saw. We were floating pretty sturdy around 40 viewers. No, I haven't, but I just wanted to make sure, because people in the chat said that they could at least hear me, and I wanted to say thank you to everybody. Final thoughts, be good to each other, pick up your trash. You guys know the drill. I'm going to go ahead and close out the stream. Everybody on the panel, stay still for a minute. But everyone in the live chat and everybody watching, thank you guys. Oh, I've got a really excellent interview. If you guys in the live can still hear me, next Friday I've got Ken Humphreys. That's going to be a good show. So thanks, everybody, and we will see you next week.